Hey everybody, we got Misty Rood here coming into the shop to deliver bells. Check out these really cool bells that we sell in the shop here. Here's a new color pattern. The old Mexican flag, right?
Mexican hat.
Anyway, bright colors, because when you set the hook, and sometimes you don't get the bell out of the rod in time, but you set that hook and that bell goes flying, and you want to be able to find it. That's why the bright colors. Okay, so what I wanted Misty to do here is to explain, though, is how exactly you use these things. What's the wire about? Do you bend it? Where do you put it on the rod? I mean, how do you use these?
Not everybody. Well, it's just kind of an adjustment. It just depends on where you're fishing on the bank. Everybody likes to position them different.
Let me hold this for you. All right, so let's say we got this in the rod holder here.
Okay, so we put the tubing on here, so a lot of people, they'll put it in their eye for adjustment and stuff. You want to make sure that it's not damaging the eye, your ceramic on the inside and stuff. Okay. But a lot of people, they want to make sure that the bell is centered in the middle. Every hook set's going to be different, obviously. So your level of your bank, where your pole is going to be positioned and stuff, you just kind of want to make sure that your center is centered. That way you're going to get a proper sound.
Okay. So, yeah. All right. So do you ever bend the wire?
You can adjust, because on your different levels of bank and stuff.
Yeah, if you're down like this, you're going to need to bend the wire, you know, to just bend it.
Everything's adjustable.
Yeah.
Because everybody fishes in so many different areas, you just want to make sure that you're going to get the best sound out of the bell. So everybody's able to adjust.
All right. Well, that makes sense. That's pretty cool. The little rubber thing on there, so you don't hurt your eye, because that's super important. You don't scratch your ceramics here, because that will cut your line.
For sure.
Now, also, bells, they ring this way, but not so much this way, and that's by design, right?
Yeah, that way, because your pole's going to go downwards and stuff. Right. Your pole's not going to go side to side.
Yeah, but the wind goes side to side, so it'll ring this way with a bite, but the wind, you won't
get
false rings.
It's not going to move it.
With the wind so much.
Yeah.
That's the idea, I think.
That's what we hope, anyway.
So, yeah, we got these cool bells in here. We sold a lot of them ever since we sold them. And then also, Missy and her husband Travis, right?
Yep.
They do these real simple plunking spreaders.
Yep.
And I tell you what, these have become very popular. You guys sent me a few just to check out, and I put them out and sold them like real fast.
They're a hot item.
Give me 100 of them.
And we can make them in various sizes. We make small, bigger. This is the larger size, but we can do smaller. We've had people, for trout. They're out on the counter.
So we've got two sizes. Mm-hmm. Right? Yeah. So, and these have become known around here as the spreaders with the green beads. So,
we do green and pink. Yeah, that's kind of our colors.
Green, because that's what people are calling them around here. But yeah, we got these. They're on the by the cash register here.
Yep.
Really good spreaders. Right on. Thanks, Misty.
You're welcome.
So, looking forward to catching some fish. You can get some plunking gear. Get in here.
There we go.